Hi, stick around for today's video. We're gonna be taking this plastic food container and turning it into a magically sweet giant candy gumdrop. Perfect for a gingerbread Christmas display. You'll start with a plastic container. I found this food container with the lid at the 99 Plus store, or use a small waste paper basket, which I got at the dollar store, so you don't have to spend much money. Spray painting them in bright colors will mimic an actual gumdrop. I recommend a paint and primer combo. When spray painting, the first coat should go on very lightly because it can run. I did 3 coats on each container, and by the time I got to the 3rd coat, you can spray it on a little bit heavier, and that'll cover any areas that need it. Let dry completely between each coat and before you go to the next step. Most projects I looked at will use glitter on the gumdrop. And one, I knew I was gonna need a lot, so I was interested in a less expensive option. 2, I think I have trauma over using glitter ribbon and finding glitter for months afterward. So I was looking for an alternative. I was looking for something that looked like actual sugar crystals. I tried the white sand first, but that basically just gave the gumdrops texture. The true winner were these toy stuffing beads. Yes, the kind that you find on this cute little guy. I bought them on Amazon, and I'll leave the link to both below in the details. I was surprised by how well they were packaged, so you don't have to worry about anything leaking anywhere in shipping. They're in a bag that's in a bag that's in a bag. And the beads are very lightweight, so they stick pretty well. After your spray paint has fully dried, you're going to apply the spray adhesive for the sand, or sugar, texture. Honestly, you could probably pass on this step and just use the beads, or use only the sand. Both may be lost from a distance visually if you're going to have these outdoors, but I'm gonna go ahead and show this step, although I think if I were to do it all over again, I might just use the beads. The spray adhesive will stay sticky for several minutes, giving you ample time to sprinkle the sand lightly over the container. And I let them dry for 24 hours before I went to the next step. To firmly secure the beads in the plastic container, use clear PVC or all-purpose cement. This will not only ensure that the beads will stay in place, but it'll also waterproof your project as well. The glue comes with an applicator. Working in small sections, spread the glue and sprinkle on the beads. It's pretty thick, so try a light coat, and since the beads don't weigh much, they'll be fine without you having to go extra heavy with the glue. And within 10 minutes, honestly, they were already staying in place. But allow them to dry a full 24 hours for them to cure. And since we haven't had much rain here in Northern California, I wanted to test things out before I added them to my Christmas display. Note the sophisticated high-end film quality with this simulated rain. And we have weatherproofing success. I finished up the rest of the containers, but before I show you the full display, I'd like to share with you some of my failures. I'm hoping this will save you from all the trouble it caused me. Not all glue is meant for this project, and I went through several options before I found something that worked. Spray adhesive. Although the beads stuck to it, just lightly touching them would cause them to fall out. Mod Podge, one of my favorite go-tos, also didn't pan out, and it would take forever to do it this way. Ain't nobody got time for that. And they continue to fall off. So I thought, hey, I'll add more spray glue. And I'll go heavier this time, thinking that that may have been the issue. So I sprayed a lot. And same results. Then I purchased some spray urethane, hoping that it would lock the beads in place and also waterproof the project at the same time. Yeah, this looks familiar. Oh, and then I tried the standard craft glue. Also, just a bad idea. So this entire project almost got tossed in the trash, or at the very least, there was no hope of me doing a video tutorial. until I found the glue that worked the best. Note that the PVC glue can possibly shrink as it dries, and some of the paint may pull back. I didn't find it too unappealing when it happened, and the fact that the beads were secure, I could look past anything at this point. So here we are in my front yard with the full gingerbread display out for the neighborhood to enjoy. I'm happy that it worked out and that I can share my success and my failures with you. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this holiday craft project and would like to see more, please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing the video. Thank you so much, and happy crafting!